Sarge Sanders in the four-round exhibition fight, and we have the weigh-in results. Tyson weighed 241.5, and Sanders a whopping 292 pounds.
Now, this is actually down from Sanders' weight in other fights. Now, Sanders just lost a fight earlier this week.
He fought a real fight earlier this week, a 10-round decision loss.
And he's got a real screwy eye and looks all weird. I don't know.
It was one was rolled in the back of his head. This one was going over here somewhere. Hopefully he doesn't see Tyson's punches coming. Hopefully Tyson can get a great...
Because in that fight that he lost, it sounded like the guy probably was running from him. And he caught the guy in the last round and knocked him down.
And he said that the referee actually counted to 8 twice, and then he counted 9 twice, and then he actually lifted the guy off the mat. Don't know if that happened, of course, but, you know, whatever.
Hopefully Tyson can win this. I mean, he's already got his next fight set up for November 10th.
November 10th, the next pay-per-view, again, for Tyson. Same day as the Holyfield pay-per-view.
$30 pay-per-views here, ridiculous.
They are killing us with pay-per-views. Hopefully he wins, period, because I'm a little worried. But he's already said not to really expect much. I think that's just him talking down on himself like he does a lot anyway. But hopefully he gets in there and really destroys
I'm not going to expect much. I mean, at this point, why would we? But, yeah, I'm not going to... expect a lot. I just hope he goes in there and at least still looks halfway decent. That'd be nice.
It would. And
after his last fight, it's going to be tough. It's going to be rough.
Because he's fighting a better fighter than he fought in his last fight, in Kevin McBride.
And this is the first Tyson fight that I'm looking forward to, but I'm also, it's the first one I'm really going into worried as hell, like, what's going to happen.
Yeah.
It's a different looking forward to feeling for this Tyson fight. Most of them I'm pumped, ready to see Tyson knock the fuck out of someone.
You know, and you just don't know what's going to happen anymore. And it's an exhibition fight, which takes away some of the glamour from it, I guess. And
it's another choke.
This weekend we have Ivan Calderon fighting in Puerto Rico in another fight that will not be shown here.
It's going to be on the Irene Pacheco card.
Yeah.
If you care, and, but either way, it's not going to be shown here.
No. So we need a link.
It'd be nice for someone to give us that.
Yeah, and people have been giving us links very quickly, so we definitely appreciate
that.
We
really appreciate it.
And keep it up, please.
And we will comment on the fight after seeing it.
Yeah, definitely. And
Calderon should win.
Yeah, he should win. I'm going to pick a decision because he's not a powerful guy at all, but.
Don't even know who he's fighting?
Some guy with one loss. It doesn't matter who he's fighting at all. But anyway, he should win. Hopefully he can get some bigger fights. And
you go quiet enough, smoke.
No, absolutely
not. Enough smoke.
But anyway, on Saturday also, the pay-per-view from Golden Boy, Juan Manuel Marquez, his fight with Jim Rex Jaca is now off. But anyway, Marquez not fighting at all. They've replaced this card now with two fights that are absolutely terrible, and Andre Berto is still on the off-TV portion of the fight, of the card, and still will not be shown. Absolutely unacceptable. So.
Yep. One guy might be okay, because Freddie Roach is training one guy. Jerry Penaloso, which I believe was on something else.
Yeah, the Pacquiao Larios undercard earlier this year. Yeah.
Over there.
I would rather see Berto.
Oh, absolutely.
Absolutely. And well, in the two fights that do matter that are being shown, Juan Lazcano is fighting against someone. Doesn't matter. He should come up with a good win. And Fonseca Leon, Daniel Day Leon.